a champion's vision to return a sport to its roots. Four competitors enter, only one leads. Ski racing in its purest form, a head-to-head battle over natural terrain. First to the bottom wins. The ultimate test of skill, intensity, aggression, and speed. This is the Rahlves Banzai Tour. You're watching the Red Bull Signature Series. I'm Sal Masekela, your host for the Red Bull Signature Series, and welcome to the fourth and final stop of the Rahlves Banzai Tour. Now, the first three stops of this tour, bluebird and sunshine. Today, not so much. This morning, we were greeted by a new storm that has brought with it high winds, new snow, and fog, making an already challenging course even more so. You have four races going side by side down steep, all-natural terrain that features tight chutes and massive step-down moguls. And that means no matter how dialed in your equipment is or any previous accomplishments, there are no guarantees for success. This is raw ski racing at its finest, and it is truly a test of both mental and physical toughness.
Banzai is a war for other people battling down the course.
It's out of control, on the edge, just balls to the wall skiing.
Top to bottom, first one wins.
It's all of your skills put into one run.
The Banzai course is like no other course I've ever skied.
You go as fast as you can, and you do anything you can to beat the other guys to the bottom.
Welcome to the incredibly stormy environment that is Sugar Bowl, California for the Rahlves Banzai Finals. Alongside Johnny Mosley, I'm Luke Van Valen. We've got Tina Dixon down in the gate, going to be interviewing some of the athletes. And Johnny, just a howler of a day as we get ready for the first men's round of 16 here.
Well, conditions are nasty, but what's great about this side-by-side format is that unlike racing or freestyle, everyone's on the same course. Everyone's experiencing the same weather at the same time, so it's even.
Absolutely. Well, it looks like Eric Bryant out front in front of the four. Remember, two move on from this event into the semifinal round. Jordan Basile's in blue, B. Devine in green, and John Lange in red.
And this course is not all about speed. It's so much about strategy. And considering this visibility, there is no definition between with this light. You can't see what's a mogul, what's a gate. You see everyone making speed checks, trying to figure out what they're gonna encounter next is radical.
Oh man, and a big wide turn right there taken by B. Devine, and he hops a big pass right there out in front of Eric Bryant.
And you see him wiping his goggles there. He made the pass probably completely blind, goggles fogged up, scraping him off, but an incredible performance. B. Devine taking the lead.
And just look at this for that second transfer spot. Looks like Lange comes around the right side and passes Bryant. There's B. Devine way out in front, and Bryant goes down, making contact with that gate as they approach the finish line. Looks like it's going to be B. Devine in first place and John Lange in second.
That was a radical race, and it's classic. You got the freestyler B. Devine versus the racer Lange, and it was B. Devine who popped off the mogul, took a different route through the middle of the course, went Daron's way, and then came through, took a tight line, and literally passed Lange in the air right there, and then straight lined the moguls to take the win.
And B just racing down there, absorbing all those bumps and some conversation down in the corral between the athletes. They're no doubt talking about the visibility. B Divine wiping his goggles after a major pass. So we look back up to the top at a clearer day out here. Of course, the run itself has been overtaken by fog, but we had a chance to show you the course from a day when the sun was shining.
Well, of course, it starts at the top of Sugar Bowl, and Daron Rahlves, the Super G World Champion, the creator of this event, is showing us the way. A big left-hander at the top and then into the corridor of death, as the athletes call it. High consequences for crashing there. And then a slight left into a chicane as they go past Dinosaur Rock there. They drop into the Love Canal. Super gnarly and steep, firm conditions. And then there's two places when they hit the crux. They can either go left on Daron's way, or Daron's dash, excuse me, or right on Woody's way, as we saw B Divine take Daron's dash for the pass. And then it's the Silver Belt Gully, of course, exiting over a wind lip. And then they enter the waterfall, a field of moguls that they pretty much need to straight line if they want to win. And of course, as they go through there, you see Daron absorbing, staying in safety position so he can make the Rahlves red line and all the way through the finish arch.
Well, it truly was a bluebird qualifier when Daron Rahlves took to the course. The Banzai master himself doing big things, but things change quickly out here without question, as we can see. Howling winds, fog, and very, very icy and deep snow conditions in some places. Of course, the wind blowing it off to the side in some spots.
And it's the visibility, which is the big factor here. That course is skiing nothing like we just saw Daron go down. The only person who could perhaps ski it that fast is maybe Daron. We'll see him later. So the hole shot becomes so important, and you see a front flip and recovery right out of the gate.
It looks like Marcus Cassett in blue is taking the hole shot. In green, we've got Connor Pelton. Connery Ludeen is in red, and Sean Collin in yellow. They're ripping down the section, and it looks like...
And you see them just coming to a snail's pace as they come into the Love Canal, making speed checks, trying to see where they're going.
Big hard turns, and looks like Kasten, who took the hole shot, still out front, knowing that he needs to distance himself as much as possible from the athletes in his rear view.
It's a fine line. You want to stay in the front of your boots as much as possible, but you can't stuff your tips into something that you don't see. And here he is, wiping his goggles, taking a look behind him as he enters into this waterfall section. I mean, have you ever tried to ski bumps when you can't see underneath it? It's nasty.
And that's a frequent result. We saw Collin just get bumped right there. And oh, on the corner of the screen, you can see his skis just go flying. And looks like it's Kasten way out front, but he is followed now by a new man in the transfer position. That's Connery Lundeen.
And Kasten, the 23-year-old from Alta ski racer. He was last year's overall Banzai Tour champion. Looks like he's going for it again.
And a great strategy, seemingly, just getting out front and maintaining that position by really turning the gas on.
Well, and he's got great fundamentals. You see him staying on his downhill ski, keeping that edge biting, real nice form, keeping the feet underneath him, not getting too far in the back seat. And he led the race and dominated the whole way.
Well, there's a look at our finalist, Marcus Kasten, and he and Lundeen will be moving on to semifinals. We'll be back with more action from the Rahlves Banzai Tour final right after this. Stay with us. The Red Bull Signature Series is brought to you by Casio Cheese One Commando. Tougher is smarter. By Camp Woodward Action Sports Camps. By The Red Bulletin, a beyond the ordinary magazine. And by Ally Ride Shop, for all your favorite brands.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series, everybody. If you're not yet involved in the conversation, get involved. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Now, for most of us, B Being clocked at 93 miles an hour probably means that you got a speeding ticket and maybe had to do some traffic school. But for Daron Rahlves, 93 miles an hour, that's how fast he's been clocked on skis. The most decorated American skier in history at 38 years old shows no sign of letting up.
I think my biggest achievement in skiing was just longevity in the sport and staying healthy and consistently being in there in the top group for a number of years, especially at the end of my career. I was progressively getting better every season. Looking back, like I was scrappy and you know, I was willing to take all the risks. I didn't care the outcome if I was gonna crash or blow it. Like I just wanted to like see how far I could push it. The one highlight for sure was Kitzbühel every year, but the year I won the Buell in 2003. Honeycomb was the biggest, like, most emotional feeling I've ever had, and winning a Super G World Championship, you know, a number of other races, but I think some other standouts were Beaver Creek, winning on home turf in the U.S., or one time to shine as a ski racer in front of the hometown crowd. My dream was to be the fastest in the world one day, and I did that. The next goal is to be the best in the world every time I kick out of the gate, and some days it happens, some days it doesn't, but you know, those days where I came on top just were that much sweeter. Filming with like TGR, going to Alaska, like I want to find something that I've never done before and ski something the way no one else can ski it. Somebody just like look at it and just go, damn, like, you know, that can be done. Skiing is such a cool sport. You know, I see others like tap into that like euphoric state and just get all excited, and that's what it's all about. I want to pass that along, and I've been doing that a long time to like the racers in this local area and looking at Sugar Bowl a lot with their ski academy and ski team. But now, I mean, I have more of a vested interest in my own family, and to have my twins, 4.5-year-olds, and just see them light up and laugh about the simplest little things in life, it keeps you grounded a little bit, and they're a lot of fun, and like, it's gonna be a blast the next couple of years. I decided to create this event, the Banzai event, because it blends free skiing and racing. I'm trying to utilize as much natural terrain as possible. It's all off-piste, nothing's man-made. And I just basically set a course that would be most fun to me, skiing top to bottom with speed and hit as much terrain as possible. It's all about getting down to the bottom as fast as you possibly can in front of everybody else.
Well, Luke, I've been friends with Daron Rahlves for a long time, and besides just being a ridiculously good skier, he's a great champion and excellent ambassador for the sport of skiing.
Well, the scene is set for the final round of 16. Keep your eyes peeled on the red bib. John Bochnik, current points leader. He's won two stops already, but Kyle Smain in green, second in points leading, so he's moving in hot, and they're shoulder to shoulder to kick things off.
Well, they both know how key it is to get the lead. If you're right behind the leader, you're eating his dust, all the spray, especially this low fist. And there goes Smain, almost going down, leaning way out onto his uphill ski, but a nice recovery. And coming into the love canal, and there goes Bochnik into the fencing, lean way into his left. And I wonder if Smain knows that Bochnik is down. He can take it easy into the waterfall section. Let's see if Bochnik can catch up.
So Bochnik really trying to fill that space left behind by that crash that he suffered, and there pulling up in the yellow bib, is Brian Walker.
And remember, the top two advance, so Bochnik, oh, there goes Smain, the tips a gate, he goes down. There goes Bochnik and Walker, it's a three-car pileup, and it's how fast, look, and Smain is below the cat track. He's gonna have to hike up to get back on the course.
Oh, that deeper snow slowing him down right now, and Walker taking advantage of the open door. Remember, top two move on to the semifinal.
And here they go, and the mogul into the moguls. You can tell he's definitely got some race technique, and now the straight line through the waterfall. This is all guesswork right here. Into the Daron's red line. You would have never predicted that result coming out of the top.
Oh, no doubt. John Bochnik coming through and taking it in the first place position, and then Brian Walker coming up in second. So there's a look at the two athletes moving on to semifinals, and that was a heated race. Just the random dynamic races out here. So different each time.
so exciting this course provides for so much passing. You see Schmeen sucks up that bump nice into the Love Canal, control of the race. Bochnik goes down behind him. Schmeen has this race won. Then he hooks a tip and goes powder skiing.
So it's John Bochnik and Brian Walker who take it and will be moving on to the semifinals. Here's a look at the overall leaderboard. Heat 1 will consist of Kasten, Devine, Lundin, and Lange, while Heat 2 will be Walker, Zafaro, Riva, and Bochnik. So big names and good times on the way. We'll be right back with more action from the Rahlves Banzai Tour on the Red Bull Signature Series right after this.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series here at the fourth and final stop of the Rahlves Banzai Tour. And yesterday, Daron, when we took our little stroll down the course, night and day conditions, I actually felt like maybe I could be a racer.
Well, you could see yesterday, right?
Yeah.
No, I mean, you did a great job on the way down.
Thank you very much, Captain.
Smooth and found the right line. And now the hardest thing is full commitment out of the gate because you can't even see the first turn.
Yeah.
And then behind some of the guys, too, there's a lot of like snow kicking off. It's, I mean, it's never perfect conditions here.
That's why it's the Banzai Tour.
That's why it's a Banzai. It's all about, a challenge. And I like to see these guys come out and face the challenges that Mother Nature has, the course that Mother Nature builds, the course that I set. And here at Sugar Bowl is like the, it's going to be the best showdown here. So I'm ready for it. And these other guys aren't holding back either.
For sure. Conditions night and day from the first three stops where you had nothing but bluebird conditions. We're going to take a look back at those first three stops of the tour.
Thanks, Sal. Well, it was bluebird skies as the 2012 Rahlves Banzai Tour kicked off at Kirkwood Mountain Resort. The California sun fueled the intensity, and there was no doubt Banzai season had arrived. In the final, it was defending champion John Bochnik taking on George Rodney, Lucas Matlich, and the 2011 overall tour winner, Marcus Kasten. Rodney secured the hole shot and led the race into Snow Snake Gully. But it was there that Bochnik made his move, passing Rodney in the first set of S's and holding off Matlich for the win, claiming his second straight Kirkwood title. Then it was on to Alpine Meadows for stop two of the tour. Alpine boasted a fast top-to-bottom course with a steep mogul face dubbed Mosley's Moguls. They proved to be the deciding factor, and in the final, it was Marcus Kasten, Jesse Maddox, Bochnik, and South Lake Tahoe's Kyle Smain. Out of the gate, Smain took the hole shot, leading the race into Wolverine Bowl. Entering Mosley's Moguls, Bochnik went for the pass, attempting an all-out straight line for the win. It was the crash heard round Tahoe as Bochnik's hopes for a second straight victory evaporated, and Kyle Smain held strong to claim the win. Stop three of the tour headed to the legendary Squaw Valley, where the blue Sierra skies baked up a leg-burning experience that added a whole new element to the grueling race. In the final, it would be a rematch as Kyle Smain and John Bochnik squared off with Squaw Valley's John Lange and Todd Disbro. Out of the gate, it was Smain to the front as the pack headed into the mini Hahnenkamm. But this time, Smain couldn't hold on, crashing in the bumps as Bochnik blew past and raced toward his second Rahlves Banzai Tour win of the season, advancing a third place Todd Disbro to the super final and setting the stage for Sugar Bowl.
With two strong wins on the Rahlves Tour this season, Johnny Bochnik is showing himself to be somewhat of a dominator. But how will he fare in the super final against some of the Tour's former champions and the legend himself, Daron Rahlves? We'll find out the super final coming up here on the Red Bull Signature Series, a television series unlike any other. Conceived by the athletes themselves, the Red Bull Signature Series places the planet's most fearless athletes center stage. Over 20 of the most progressive and innovative competitions in countries all over the globe unleashed in one epic series. Mountain biking pushes to new extremes as freeriders chart the uncompromising terrain of Red Bull Rampage. Enduro bike riders confront the hardcore terrain of Transylvania.
in Red Bull Romania. 500,000 fans swarmed to see high-performance surfing from the world's best at the U.S. Open of Surfing. And the collective energy of thousands surges in the mother of all freestyle motocross events, Red Bull X Fights. Prepare to believe in the unbelievable as these athletes attempt to make the impossible possible. The Red Bull Signature Series is the evolution of sports. Watch all year long on NBC and the NBC Sports Network. Go to RedBullSignatureSeries.com for complete schedule details.
When you're standing in that start gate and you're looking down that course, it's scary.
Your heart is pounding.
Just try and focus on the gate. Just worry about yourself, because that's all you can control.
Take deep breath, really think about the line I'm trying to pick, and try and stay calm.
They go to attention, 5 seconds, and you gotta be ready to go. It's just, everything goes quiet, and as soon as that gate drops, you gotta get out as fast as possible.
There's other guys around you, and they're gonna be pushing hard, just always focusing on that gate, and when it drops, pulling as hard as you can.
Nerves definitely play a factor in Banzai. You gotta be able to control them, you know. Everybody's nervous up there.
You know, you've gotta get out and try and get out in front of those guys, so, you know, the adrenaline's running, and you're kind of sizing up who's around you and figuring out, you know, how can I time this thing to give myself the best advantage possible.
Whether or not it's beating the person next to you or the three people next to you, you're gonna give it all you have.
Well, the wind continues to howl out here at Sugar Bowl as we get close to the semifinals here at the Rahlves Banzai Tour Finals. Alongside Johnny Mosley, I'm Luke Van Valen. We've got Tina Dixon out in the corral ready to interview some of the athletes. And semifinal heat one is ready to get underway. Johnny Lang in red, Connery Lundin in green, B. Devine in blue, and Marcus Kasten in yellow.
And Lundin in green with a huge hole shot way out in front. And Lange right behind him. Lundin maintaining the land lead, and he is nuking. See if he can hang on in these low light, low visibility conditions.
Well, flying through that section right there, seemingly holding on at this point, maybe the battle for second place at this point. Remember, top two move on to the final round.
And they're using everything they got in the bag. You see guys snow plowing, sliding sideways, check turns, just trying to do anything they can to keep the speed up, but keep it in control. A nice job by Connery getting through this section, and the race has got really tight here.
And Marcus Kasten moving up and taking over the lead right there. He comes into first, but oh, passing outside of the right is John Lange.
He could not hang on to it, exploded, and there goes B. Devine right past Connery. Again, B. Devine makes a last minute pass and he will advance.
What an upset there, just at the top of the waterfall, and a switch up in places. The back becomes the front, and the front goes down. So John Lange and B. Devine will be moving on to the finals. Excitement in the air, Mosley, as they pound fists yet again.
Well, Lundin gets the hole shot in the green, but then he slows up into the waterfall, and that's when Kasten blows by. Then he blows up, double ejectos. Lange takes the lead on the right.
Beautiful gameplay right there. We go down to the bottom where Tina Dixon's with our top two.
John Lange, you guys are both moving on into the finals. How challenging is that final race going to be for you guys?
Oh, it's going to be a big challenge. There's a lot of good skiers out there. You can't see anything. There's big bumps out there, and you just kind of got to pretend you know where they are and hope for the best.
And it's all about natural terrain, and it's natural out there. That's for sure.
Yeah, just juiced up. We're about to get a big snowstorm, so stoked to shred some power. Just got to keep the ice off the gogs on the way down. Should be good.
All right, best of luck to both of you guys in the final. Back to you.
Thanks a lot, Tina. Certainly some great racing up there as we head back up to the top for Heat 2 of semifinals. One of the gentlemen in this race, John Bochnik. He's been dominant on this tour. Let's take a closer look at the man from Squaw Valley.
Growing up ski racing, Daron Rahlves was always my hero. And so the Rahlves Banzai Tour was like a catch for me. It's the way I like to free ski. Racing four at a time adds a whole nother perspective. I was up for the challenge for sure. I'm competitive, and once I'm in that gate, I want to win every single heat. Going into Kirkwood, first heat, I just got the whole shot, pulled away, just smoked down the hill, and I knew it was going to be a good day from there. Once I knew I could win, I was like, well, let's win the overall. People recognize me everywhere, and they're like, you won the last Banzai, or you crashed at Alpine in the lead, and my family loves it. I'm probably like it the least out of everyone. My mom's like, oh, let's Twitter, oh, let's make a fan page. I'm like, fan page? Come on, I'm gonna be made fun of. I work with my dad. My dad always wanted to be a ski racer growing up, and so me being successful, he takes a lot of pride in it for sure. He's kind of got that go fast mentality too, so it's great working with him. I push myself, I think, more than anything to perform. I just want to be consistently good. I don't want to win one and not even appear in the semifinals and the rest of them. I want to be consistently good and be at the top of the sport.
Well, there's Bochnik in red. If he can finish in the top two, he's the overall champion here today. Walker's in yellow, Zafaro in blue, and Riva in green.
And Bochnik with a great pull out of the gate, takes the whole shot, but Casey Riva from Telluride is right on his tails.
Coming around this hard corner right here, it looks like visibility has not improved, but Bochnik holding on to his edges down this slope.
Well, Bochnik in the red bib is all over the place, but it's effective. Casey Riva hanging in there, though, as they come into the Love Canal. Some nice check turns by Bochnik, keeping it under control. What happens when they come into the crux? There goes Casey Riva to the right. Bochnik to the left on Daron's way. And it pays off. Bochnik loses out to Riva, who makes the pass down the Silver Belt Gully. And let's see if he can hang on through the waterfall.
Well, virtually unprecedented at this point. The points leader of the entire season in second place, and Riva looking strong.
And it's so nasty in those bumps. You lose the rocks, you lose the trees, the visibility goes to zero.
And look at this, the newcomer out of Telluride flying down that hardcore lane, the Rahlves red line, and he's coming over to the finish line first, and he's done it. He's beaten the points leader, but with that second place, Bochnik will clench the overall Banzai title for 2012.
Well, they can both celebrate for now. Riva for moving on to the final, Bochnik for clinching the overall title and moving on to the final, and Bochnik there getting a hug from his dad. They worked together on the race crew at Squaw Valley. He's been dominant all season. There he goes, absorbing that energy into the Love Canal, but it was Riva who took the faster route on the right, Woody's way, and passed Bochnik into the Silver Belt Gully.
Unbelievable performance by both athletes there. Riva taking it up to the top, and they're down with Tina Dixon.
Casey, going into the split, you were right behind Johnny. What happened there?
I was just right on his tails. He took the left route. I tried to pass on the right and came into the gully pretty much neck and neck. And from there, just kept going. Just wanted to win.
Well, you guys got one more race heading into the finals. Are you going to change anything up there with the weather?
I'm going to save myself for the super final. I just clinched my overall title, and I'm stoked. It's going to be a good day. Already is a good day.
Let's talk about that. The overall, you've had a fantastic year. What has been key for you this year?
Just staying on my feet for the majority of every run, and I'm fast and quick on my feet. It's helped me a lot.
Well, congratulations on the overall. You got a final and a super final. Looking forward to that. All right, guys.
Thanks a lot, Tina. Well, the scene is set for the final. B. Divine out of Squaw Valley, California. Casey Riva, John Bochnik, and John Lange will all be fighting for that top spot here at the Rahlves Banzai Tour 2012. That's the men's ski final still on the way from Sugar Bowl.
Welcome back to the Red Bull Signature Series. As you can tell by my dreadsicles, it is dumping snow here at the Rahlves Banzai Tour. Shelly Robertson, she's the points leader for the women. How about we get to know her?
For me, coming out to the Banzai is all about getting that adrenaline rush and getting my heart pumping. Banzai is a really personal experience because each run that you do and that you progress, you're like gaining that confidence in yourself so that when you're going in that final heat, you're completely ready and know that you can win. I wouldn't be out here if I didn't want to win and, you know, have fun and ski with all these amazing skiers. I think the significance of winning an overall title is a really good feeling because that means that you were consistent throughout the whole season. You just want to push yourself to the max. And after retiring from the US ski team 2 years ago, I'm starting to realize that there's not many other aspects of your life where you can get your heart rate up. The Banzai gives you that heart pumping excitement, and that's what I like about it.
Well, I watched her growing up in Squaw and then take it to the World Cup Mogul Tour, winning World Cups there, second in the Red Bull Cold Rush last year, definitely one of the world's best overall skiers.
Well, as we take a look back at the women's final, Shelly Robertson hops out into that first place position here, getting the whole shot.
Well, she was telling me how important it was to get out in front. You see her throw some short swing turns to the Love Canal, going back to some mogul technique, and now this should be her forte, coming through the waterfall, and bam!
Right across the finish line, and with that, Shelly Robertson clinches the 2012 title. And Tina Dixon had a chance to catch up with her.
Congratulations, Shelly, in the start up there. How important was that hole shot? You just ran away with it.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah, today was really difficult with the snow and the wind, that I knew I had to get out in front so that I didn't have to deal with one more element. And so I pushed as hard as I could out of that gate and tried to get to the first gate first.
Now, you spent 11 years on the U.S. team, and to be able to come to the Banzai Tour and take this win, what does this mean?
Yeah, it's huge. I mean, I retired from the team and I just wanted to do a couple fun events, and so to come out here and do well means a lot, and I think Daron's doing an amazing job and I'm excited to be a part of it.
Congratulations on the win.
Thank you so much.
All right, guys.
Thanks a lot, Tina. A spectacular performance from Shelly Robertson. And in that second place, Shannon Rahlves. So big ups to both the ladies there, and a very, very intense women's final. We got men's finals coming up shortly right here from Sugar Bowl, and it's been an unbelievable day thus far. Johnny Mosley with me, and we'll be making the call when we come back to the Rahlves Banzai Tour final. Stay with us. Well, the men's ski finals scene is set. B Divine, Casey Riva, John Bochnik, and John Lange all moving into this very intense and sought-after position of the start gate at the top. As you can see, storms continue to loom over, heavy winds as we prepare for the men's final.
And Lange closest on the screen in front of us. And it looks like Bochnik in green is out in front, down on the right side. Oh, and Bochnik goes down right away. Lange moving into second place, and Riva has moved into first in the blue bib.
Riva with his foot on the gas pedal in a big way out in front yet again. He had the fastest line and was able to beat Bochnik earlier in the day, but Lange right on his tail.
And Riva drops into the Love Canal, scrubbing some speed, but Lange is right behind him. Visibility could not be worse, and they are pointing it and letting him straight. It looks like they took the skier's right line, which is how Riva passed Bochnik last time.
Comes flying in there, up and over the wind lip. Nothing ahead of him except the waterfall. Heavy, big mogul field ahead. Anything can happen in this big left turn.
Important to keep your skis on through this section. Lange just all over the place, trying to put on the power to catch Riva, but he cannot be stopped. Casey Riva coming out of nowhere from Telluride to win the men's final.
Unbelievable. Riva takes it right there, and throwing on the brakes right behind him is Lange. He's adjusting his helmet cam, and Riva signing up for this competition just because he was in town, and B Divine coming up in that third place spot.
Well, it's just a nasty race. I mean, these guys can't see anything. It's what you call skiing by braille. You just let the tip of your ski hit whatever it is and keep your legs nice and supple and try to absorb everything possible.
Well, here's a look back up to the top where Bochnik went down. Look at him veer way downhill right there, trying to get back up in, but it looks like he flies off course.
He just got turned up the hill and lost his ski. It was almost pointed uphill, and then Riva takes command and just skis a clean race. But Lange got close. Lange was pushing it through the waterfall but could not catch Riva.
Well, Tina Dixon is down with our champion, Casey Riva.
Casey Riva coming out here from Telluride, and what a day of racing it was for you guys. Tell us about the start. You were second coming out of that, and then what happened?
Yeah, start was really tight. Everyone was right in there, and Johnny just got bumped a little low, and I was able to make a pass and stayed out front the rest of the way. Really challenging conditions. The lens is fogging up the whole way down, but I'm into the superfinals and feeling good.
Yeah, such difficult conditions, and you had John Lange on your tail right there at the finish line. What'd you do to keep him from passing?
Yeah, you know, you can almost sense someone's right behind you, and just made that last turn, and it's pretty blind with the visibility, and just try to go straight and fast and do what you can for yourself.
And you got the superfinals coming up. You get a chance to ski against Daron Rahlves. How motivated are you to beat him?
Oh, I'm really excited. Daron's always been an idol of mine growing up as a racer here in Tahoe, and it's going to be fun. It's my goal to make it to this, and got a shot at it, so pretty stoked.
Well, congratulations on winning the final, and he's got the super final coming up next, guys.
When we come back, the man himself, Daron Rahlves, will be defending not only his honor, but his checkbook in the men's super final. The winners from all four stops taking Daron on, not just for the championship, but 10 grand in the hand. You don't want to miss that.
Red Bull Signature Series has been brought to you by Casio Cheese One Commando, tougher is smarter. By Camp Woodward Action Sports Camps. By the Red Bulletin, a beyond the ordinary magazine. And by Ally Ride Shop for all your favorite brands. Time now for the Casio Stomped Moment of the Day. Banzai newcomer Casey Riva made an impressive Sugar Bowl debut, earning him the Casio G1 Commando Stomped Moment of the Day. After qualifying fourth, Riva threw down, advancing to the semifinals and going head-to-head with overall points leader Johnny Bochnik. In the finals, it was all Riva, taking on a hungry John Lange to claim the silver belt title and earn a spot alongside the master in the Rahlves Banzai Tour Super Final. Casey Riva, you stomped it. We're getting ready for the Rahlves Banzai Tour Super Final. Our four Tour Stop champions get a chance to go head-to-head with Daron Rahlves, the Banzai Master.
Racing in the Super Final with Daron is, you know, every skier's dream. The guy's a legend.
He is the most decorated U.S. downhill athlete ever. The lines he picks, the turns he's able to make, it's really inspiring.
It's intense because he's not given an inch of space out there on the hill, and he's going full out.
When I get in the gate against others, I'm willing to get after it still, so why hold back?
Yeah, you definitely know that you have to be on your game or else you don't have a chance.
I have a great sense of anticipation to get in the gate with Daron and have a chance to run it with the master.
I know these kids are going to be out gunning for me, man, and I'm not going to lay down and let that happen too easily.
Well, the scene is set. The athletes about to race against their hero, Daron Rahlves. You've been talking about this gentleman, Johnny, just being the man. There's Todd Disbro, age 34. Kyle Smain out of South Lake Tahoe. He's won one of the events each of these athletes have. There's John Bochnik. We've been talking about him a lot throughout the day. And Casey Riva, the newcomer to the field, who stepped up and made it happen. And then, of course, the Banzai Master himself, Daron Rahlves.
Well, you got some talented guys, but they're going to have to give it their all to get by the master. He is a ridiculously good skier. And here we go out of the gate, and it looks like Bochnik tries to get the hole shot from Daron, but doesn't happen.
Daron Rahlves already out front. You know, this just proving the fact that he is the Banzai Master, getting that hole shot, but the race far from over, Johnny.
We saw Daron just spray Bochnik, and Bochnik is still hanging in there. Daron pointing it straight down the Love Canal, no check turns at all. And there goes Riva. Bochnik goes down, but Riva is still in contention, but he is going to have to turn on the afterburners to catch Daron, who is now just straight lining all the way, no hesitation. Look at the forward lean in that guy's boots. So balanced over his skis as they enter into the waterfall.
And Ralph's pulling down in. There's Riva behind him.
Riva is right on his tails, but there goes Ralph, turns on the heat. And I don't think Riva's gonna catch him now.
Oh man, the nitrous fires up and Rahlves is across the line first, proving that he remains the Banzai Master.
An impressive job by Riva though, almost got him at the end. I think Rahlves started to feel him and figured out that he had to point it.
Unbelievable, Riva coming out of virtually nowhere with an incredible performance on the day. Daron Rahlves right there, you mentioned, keeping it together despite these insane conditions.
Look how he just straight lines right through the Love Canal, almost losing it there. Wouldn't that have been crazy for him to go down? And all the other guys did their best to keep up, but it's hard to keep up with the master.
Well, the most decorated American downhill and Super G skier in history. He has 12 World Cup races, 28 World Cup podiums, and 7 U.S. national titles. It goes on. Well, we throw things down now to Tina Dixon.
Daron out there taking the super final, but Casey almost got you at one point. How much was he pushing you?
I couldn't tell. My race was in front of me. It was so tough to see. Oh, I think it was the thickest all day, and I knew those guys were right on me. Bochnik was right there. We were going elbow to elbow in the first turn, and I just held it strong, and I knew it was either like crash or win here, and I pointed at that top, the Stahlhang, the straight here in the moguls, like without even being able to see anything. It was just like I could barely make out the Red Bull arch, and like that's where I'm going, and hold on.
Well, it's always fun watching you ski, and it was fun watching these guys ski. Impressive day down here, guys.
Well, an exemplary performance from an unbelievable athlete, and the final results look like this. Rahlves up top, Casey Riva in second, and Kyle Smain in third. Then the final point standings for the season. John Bochnik ahead by over 100 points. Kyle Smain in second, and Marcus Kasten in third. Time now for the signature moment. The Banzai Master, Daron Rahlves, led overall tour winner Johnny Bochnik into the corridor of death en route to his super final win. Well, it's been an unbelievable competition in the midst of challenging conditions. For Johnny Mosley, Tina Dixon, and myself, Luke Van Valen, we say goodbye and send it back now to Sal Masekela.
The man is 38 years old, and Daron Rahlves still treats the entire super final field like they were his children, as fast as can be, and still the man to beat. The Red Bull Signature Series continues this Saturday from the deep powder of British Columbia. You will witness snowboarding history in this two-hour television special that features the world's best riders as they take on an untouched course design by Travis Rice. Yes, that's Supernatural, and you can catch it this Saturday, March 31st, on NBC. And then 2 weeks from today, we're going skiing again. This time it's free skiing trailblazer Simon Dumas hosting a slope-style pro-am from his house. Well, actually his home mountain of Sunday River, Maine. You can catch the Dumont Cup April 10th right here on the NBC Sports Network. For all of our entire crew today, thanks for hanging out with us. I'm Sal Masekela, and I will see you next time.